Let's understand how does a neural network model work. For this, we are going to understand backward propagation algorithm. And in this process, we are going to understand several terms like case updating, batch updating, how does weight and bias updates, and then intuitive understanding of why it works. Then we are going to understand the stopping criteria and the analyst decisions that can affect the operations of neural network. So first thing, what you need to understand, the neural network is an iterative approach and it solves problem through iteration. Say at any given stage, when in the beginning, when you are starting, you put input nodes equal to number of independent variables and you assign random weights to these synapses. We are calling input to input hidden one as W11, from input 2 to hidden node 1 as W21, like that. So you assign these weights. Usually you assign between 0.5 to minus 0.5 to 0.5. You assign random biases, like again these biases you can call it 0.5 to 5 or 0.5 minus 0.5 to 0.5, and then you calculate your output. That's the Y which you are trying to predict. You have an actual output. Y actual minus Y predicted gives you error, that how much your prediction is away from the actual stuff. Now we will use that error to correct these thetas and these W's. That's what is backward propagation. For this, it actually can do two ways. One way is that you pass one record at a time, check, calculate the error, and then correct for the error. So you correct the thetas, bias, and you correct the weights. So here you are going one record at a time. There can be another way where what you are doing, you are actually passing. So this is case updating I talked, where what you did in fact, weights are updated after each record is run through the network, and once all the record has passed through, this is called one epoch is over. You can also call it sweep or iteration. After one epoch is completed, you return to the first record or repeat the process. That is case updating. You can also do it this way, that you pass first record, calculate the error, and keep a track of that. So essentially you recorded the error. But right now you are not going to use it for correcting these thetas and these W's. So what you are doing, you are just calculating the error and recording it. You passed another observation, again calculate error and keep record. So if you think of what you are doing, you are passing all the records and keeping the record of errors. Now you need to adjust bias and weights with the function of all the errors. You can take sum of square of errors, and based on that you can correct all the errors, all the thetas and W's. That is called batch processing. So if you think of in batch processing, what you are doing, you are in fact calculating all the errors, you know, when you're passing record one by one, and at the end of the day you are using as a function of all the errors to correct this, not with each input. So that's why it is called batch processing, because you pass the whole, all the records in one go, calculated all the errors, and then you use a function of all the errors to correct weights and thetas. Now think of, when you are passing these errors back to these thetas and W, why it gets corrected. This is how it is. So suppose your current weight and bias of the neural network produces output, call it yk, and the expected output is y, this yk hat and this is yk. So what is your error? Error is, you calculate error is like this, yk hat, which is the prediction, 1 minus yk hat, and this is actual output minus what you are getting. Now what you will do, suppose your output it's say 0.6 and expected output was 2.4, then 0.6 this is yk hat, 1 minus 0.6 this is this term, and 2.4 minus 0.6 is the this particular term. You take this error and then you use to correct weight and biases. How do you correct it? Usually like this. So if these are your old weights, you'll add L into error. So these are your old weights and these are old weights and old biases. This is old weight, old biases. These are errors and this is learning rate. Learning rate 0.5 means you're going to take it half the error. Learning means rate 2 means you're going to take double of the error. This is the error that you have. And if you think of what you're doing, if your error is positive, you're going to add to theta and W. If your error is negative, you're going to reduce theta and you're going to reduce W. In fact, because errors are used to adjust the weight and adjustment is proportionate to the error, big errors will lead to big change in weights and a small error will lead to a small change in the weights. Almost if there is a very small error, it will leave the weights almost unchanged. When you do this many times, so with many such updates, many such iterations, the weights keep changing until the error associated with the weight is negligible. After several iterations, the weights are not going to change too much. And at this point, weight changes very little. And you think this is a final. But how will you stop? How will you know that this is the time to stop? Because all said and done, weight will change little bit here and there every time. So this is how will you stop? When weights and biases hardly changes, because then you understand it's very near to the optimal value. When errors are below a threshold, when errors are itself as you know is in acceptable range, you take it fine. Or when maximum number of iteration has reached, if you have put maximum iteration 1000, whatever has happened in 1000 iterations, you'll take it as a final. So these are the three ways by which you can stop neural network from further iteration. And if you think of, there are several things that analyst can take a decision and that can make an impact on the neural network's operation. How many internal layers should be there? What should be the learning or optimization rate to adjust the weights of synapses and to adjust the weight of biases? Let me just add that particular term here. How many nodes should be in each layer? What should be the activation function? Usually, I mean, in the best case, most of the people take input nodes equal to number of independent variables, just one hidden layer, and that's how they proceed. What should be the activation function in different node? Most used function you have already seen, exp by 1 plus exp. However, people are free to take other activation function as well. How to avoid overfitting? And what is overfitting? Overfitting is like this, error modeling. So let's say these are, you know, like responder and these are non-responder. If you're making a model like this, it's fine. Suppose you are going for non-linear and you develop a model like this also is fine. But when you try to do a where you try to take care of each and every model point and then try to make a model, that's like overfitting. And what is the problem? The problem is that this will work very good in the development data, but in the validation data, it will create problem. So never go for overfitting. This should be your good enough and you should live with some errors. Some errors are bound to happen and you should be ready to live with that. So that's how this whole neural network works, where you are using the errors to adjust the bias and weights, and through several iterations, it actually takes the shape by which it can do the job.